Through me, you pass into the city of woe. Through me, you pass into eternal pain. Through me, among the people lost for aye. Justice, the founder of my fabric, moved. To rear me was the task of power divine, supreme wisdom and primeval love. Before me, things created were none, save things eternal, and eternal I endure. Abandon all hope, all ye who enter here.
Now, having listened to that powerful reading, can anyone tell me why Dante's Inferno is still so important today? Am I to abandon all hope? Lawrence?
Because he imagined hell.
Yeah. Yeah, because he imagined hell. He shared with us a version of man's experience and relationship to existence, to his sins, to his own mortality. When you all come here, ladies and gentlemen, to get lost in the classics, to be inspired by the great masters, but also to begin and to try to make sense of your own descent into hell. So instead of usual critical analysis of Dante's Inferno, I would like you to provide me with an alternative poetic proposal to Dante's hell. Your own. Your struggles, your fears, your sins, whatever they may be. Oh, and I want it by Monday. Yeah, good weekend. Bye. Thanks. Did you enjoy it?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Oh, hello, Susan. Thanks.
Aren't you the hippest professor of them all?
Oh, darling, I would never dare take that title away from you.
I didn't just publish a book. That obviously helped.
Don't worry. By this time next week, they would have forgotten all about it.
There's a rectoral dinner at my place tonight. Mm-hmm. Select professors only. Please come.
I'm afraid I can't tonight. I have plans.
Plans?
Mm-hmm.
I imagine they're not staying at home correcting exams.
Not exactly. Have a good weekend.
You too.
I think my publisher would be too happy about that.
Yes, so the writers can get over it.
You'd have to give up going to university.
Mm, never mind.
You would not?
No.
We'll never be able to make love again.
Mm. If it's only for that, we'll move.
Is
How long have we been together?
I don't know. Almost a year.
13 months.
13 months.
Mm. And no one knows.
So.
Do you love me, Samuel?
What sort of question is that?
Don't laugh. I mean serious.
Well,
I mean it. If you loved me, you wouldn't be hiding from everyone all the time.
No. But then the entire university would be gossiping about us. Is that what you want?
Just, I don't want this ever to end.
Neither do I.
Then promise me. You love me forever.
Okay.
Say it.
I promise.
Not like that, say it.
I promise. I will love you forever. Oh, hello. Hello. You hungry? You still love me, don't you? Sorry, you know. We've run out of cat food, so I'm going to have to pop out. What do you say I pick up some takeaway on my way back?
No!
This is the reference, that's what I'm saying.
At least if it's that. Do you think you can manage?
Yeah, sure. I'll get you later. Hey. I was thinking I would never see you around here again.
I'm sure there's some people who'd be delighted if that were the case.
I don't think that's true. How are you?
Does that offer for dinner still stand?
Of course.
That little girl of 5'2", amazing thing.
That sounds creepy. How long have you been having them?
Every night. For the past 3 weeks.
Are you seeing anyone to help you with this?
First I had a grief counselor, but I decided that wasn't really for me.
Sure, it has occurred to you that these dreams might have something to do with what happened.
The woman in my dreams looks nothing like Beatrice.
No, what I mean is like your head is trying to get rid of the pain that's inside it, like, you know, therapy.
It's got nothing to do with that, okay?
Have you written anything?
I've got nothing to say.
Write about your dream.
Oh, sure. I've become a horror writer.
What's wrong about that? All writers are sexy.
Oh, come on.
Poets are starving, boring. Oh. On that note, I got that for your birthday and then you disappeared, so. Better late than never. Happy birthday to you. Open it.
Now that's what I call pressure.
Oh, come on. Use it for your grocery list. Or to correct exams. You are a professor, remember? And a good one, so.
Why don't you stop biting your nails?
Fuck you.
You miss me already?
Are you at home? Samuel?
Yeah, just got back.
Switch on the TV. The local news channel. Quick.
Why?
Just do it. Do it.
Okay.
Do you have it?
Murder has shaken the quiet, leafy suburb of Bulls Bridge. A Gartha spokesman has said that the badly beaten corpse was found on the second story. Surrounded by what appears to be a makeshift white circle on the floor, Gardaí believe the event has all the hallmarks of a ritual-type killing.
Samuel.
Further forensic investigation to establish the exact course of events is currently underway.
So, she was killed a couple of days ago, and apparently a cleaning lady found her when she arrived in the morning. She was an Italian lady, and her name was Lydia Goretti, and this is the woman I saw in my dreams. This is her, I am positive.
Samuel, do you realize how incredible this is?
Yes.
You dreamt about something that was going to happen before it did. Before it did. That's called a premonitory dream.
But why me? Why? I didn't even know this woman.
I don't know. There has to be an explanation. We'll figure it out.
No, we will not. This is not one of your esoteric adventures. This woman is dead. This is real. And I saw how it happened.
Really? What are you going to do? Who are you going to talk to? The police? What are you going to say? Hi, Inspector. I know what happened to the Italian woman in Balls Bridge. I wasn't there. I saw it in my dream. Do you realize what that looks like? It's crazy.
Thank you. intend to hurt you. Just tell me what you're doing here.
Are you a policeman?
No, I'm... Well, who are you? Were you stealing?
No, I saw what happened to that woman on TV.
Did you know her?
No.
Then why?
What about you? If you're not with the police, then...
Listen, I...
You dreamt about it too, didn't you? You have to see something. Follow me. Notice anything different? I realized as soon as I came in, something's missing.
There.
Yes.
Those shelves. What was that? It was a door.
Exactly. Got some matches.
Yeah. Thanks.
Vedi la bestia per cui ho mi forse.
That's Dante.
Yeah, that's right. Whoever killed her was looking for something. Oh, you saw the house. This could be what they were after.
But she wanted us to find it. That's why we had the same dream. Think about it.
Thank you.
7. There's a waiting list.
Experimental literary circle that used to meet there. And it seems some of their concerns were too esoteric to be taken seriously. Shakespeare. The impossible sonnets. Nobody's ever been able to decipher them, including Shakespeare himself. Mm-hmm. He says they've been dictated to him in his dreams by a dark lady. Mm-hmm. Milton. My specialty. He tells of his experience of meeting a lady by the name of Hyperia on the outskirts of Florence. Mm. According to him, she was the inspiration for Paradise Lost. Keats, Blake, the references are endless. They all hint at having had some contact with the muses. Number one invites. Mm-hmm. Number two invokes. Number three lies. Number four punishes. Number five, foretells. Number six, impassions. Number seven, hides. The seven ladies.
Yeah, misses the muses.
Well, your friends from the White Ring took the subject too far. For years, they published their theories in all sorts of specialized magazines, first in academic circles, then in marginal cult publications, and in all of them, they claimed that they met them.
Inspiration taken from nature in the form of a woman.
Supernatural beings are inconceivable evil. Immortal witches invoking poetry through the use of spells. Okay. What do you think we can find these guys?
I could call Berkeley through the department. But I'm kind of getting tired of being your secretary. You went to that house without telling me. You found a treasure in some kind of aquarium, and suddenly a girl showed up out of nowhere and took it. If I had been there, that would not have happened.
So you're gonna help me find these guys or what?
Nothing. Just something I found.
Are you annoyed?
What?
I don't know. You seem weird.
What do you mean? No, baby, I'm just tired is all.
Are you going to work tonight?
Just for a little while. But I'll be back soon. I promise. And you know what?
What?
Tonight's my last night. I'm not going back there again.
Really?
Ever. Eating a noogie winner!
It's five of them. Lee Barlow, Matthew Osman, Lawrence Calder, Barry Sutton, Habit, Roshan.
Great. Can we reach them?
Wait. Lee Barlow stabbed himself 6 years ago. 28 times, to be precise. In front of his family. Matthew Osman, a strange degenerative disease that rots the tissue until the victim collapses to death. Doctors still don't understand. Barry Sutton was found dead on a Portland dock. He had been devoured from the inside by an unidentified insect. The interesting detail is they found a verse by Baudelaire scratched onto his body by a knife. Lawrence Colbert went mad. He stabbed several children who were on their way home at the school gates. The police shot him down. And you know what? They also found verses tattooed on his back. So, it looks like we have no witnesses left. That's it.
No. Wait, you just said, about Herbert Roushen.
Berkeley doesn't have any records of him. In fact, they didn't even recognize his name.
Told.
Yeah. Your agent. What a nice surprise.
I heard you were late.
Again?
I'm sorry. I'm not feeling too great.
That's a shame. Neither am I. Look at this crap I have to take. But I never late, am I?
You said that when I got to 100 grand, you'd give it back to me. That's the last of it.
And what am I going to tell the people that brought you here, Rachel, huh? You don't know them. Yeah, they're bad news. You want to leave us? You, Queen of the Horrors. After all we've been through together. We take good care of you.
You do.
We treat you well.
You do.
Don't be late again, Rachel. Ever. No. And you're mistaken. It's 150 grand, Jomie. That's the deal.
Found anything?
Yeah.
That's no surprise.
Dunquin. That's here, right?
There's a Dunquin in County Kerry.
Can you still access the Irish University's database?
He's dead, Samuel. They all are.
Yeah, but see for yourself. They never found a body. We need to look to see if he had any link with the university. Doctorates, conferences, PhDs, anything. We need to see if we can get a location on him, find an address for him living here.
You better wait up.
Oh, I love you.
You know, come get it. Come get it. You know? You know? You know? You know?
How the fuck did you get into my home?
Through the dream, I can do incredible things.
You better get out before I call the police.
We want the Imago.
What you found in the aquarium?
It belongs to us.
Who the hell are you?
You took it out of the water. You have to be the one who gives it back. Those are the rules. Get out.
What the fuck have you done with it? All right, just a sec. I'm coming.
What's your problem?
Sorry.
Are you okay? Do you need help?
Yeah, I'm just gonna clean it up. Did you find anything?
You know, you were right. In the mid-80s, Rauschen left his chair at Brown to come to Europe. He did various rotations at English universities, and then he ended up here in Cork.
Well, have you got an address from the file in Cork?
No, they say he lived on campus. There was an address in Dunquin which he cancelled right before he quit.
What does that sound like to you? It sounds to me like someone who's hiding. Who's running scared. Have you got the address?
You better let me try it.
No. No, I'm going alone.
What?
Susan.
I thought we were in this together.
Susan! Look at all this. Do you think this is all a coincidence? People who get close to this get hurt. I mean it. It's over.
Okay. You scare me right now.
Just do as I say, okay?
My name's Samuel Solomon. I'm from the university. And I was hoping to speak with Professor Rauschen.
The professor died.
I know. Tell him it's about the White Ring.
Come in.
My name is Samuel Solomon. I need to talk to you about Lydia. Lydia Goretti.
How did you find me?
I found this photo from her house. Lydia is dead. She was murdered 3 days ago.
What is it you want?
I want you to tell me what you know about her, about the White Ring, the fake shipwreck. What are you hiding from?
Seven ladies there are. That's what you came here to talk about, isn't it? We spent years studying this. Just an obsession.
What is that?
Lydia recorded this woman. Just a little demonstration.
A demonstration of what?
Of what they are.
Wait a second. Are you suggesting that Lydia...
Yes, Mr. Solomon. See who foretells.
Much anymore. And yet thou lovest me not. And never will. Love dwells not in our will. Nor can I blame thee, though it be my lot, to strongly, wrongly, vainly love thee still.
Seem as beautiful as any other, don't they? But they're traps.
What is that?
It looks harmless, doesn't it? But it kills everything I love. Friends. A child. And then another child. And then another. Everything. Lydia is not your problem. It's the other ones you have to worry about. Give them what they want. As soon as possible, do as I say.
I can't. I don't have what they want.
Then, run.
Hottest and most massive object.
Pack your things. We have to go.
Where?
I don't know. We'll see.
Why? This is our home.
No, baby, it's not. Please hurry.
Hi. I wonder if you could help me. I'm looking for a girl.
Get out.
I don't want any trouble. I just need to know where
I can
find her.
What's your problem?
I'm just looking for a girl. I think she works here. Dark hair, green eyes, Eastern European accent.
Rachel, of course.
Rachel?
You think you're the first one to come looking for her? I don't know how she makes you all lose your fucking mind.
No. I've never been here before. I met her a couple of days ago. Look, I really need to know where to find her. I need to talk to her. Please, it's important.
You're the guy with the dreams.
She told you about them. Look, she's in danger. I just want to try and help her. Please.
All right. She lives in one of the apartment blocks in St. Teresa's garden. I think it's the last one. That's all I know.
Thank you.
I can't leave my stuff here, Mom.
I'll buy you other toys, I promise.
But I don't want other toys.
Just pick one. Your favorite, yeah?
This one.
Oh, that's too big.
This one, please.
Maybe that's even bigger.
Hello, Rachel. Have you forgotten who got you this shithole?
Get to the bedroom. Now, go!
Very obedient, isn't he? Didn't get that from you.
What do you want?
I was looking for your passport. You know, I wanted to keep to my word. Do you know what? I couldn't find it.
Please don't hurt us, don't hurt myself.
Darling, what do you take me for? Huh? What do you take me for? Tonight I come in peace. Tonight, you come by the club, we have a few drinks,
boogie woogie. It's all forgotten about. Yeah?
Hmm?
First, Rachel, you and I, we're going to have a, we're just going to have a little talk, yeah? So you can straighten things out.
Hey boys, I'm looking for a girl. She's got short dark hair, she's very pretty.
You a cop?
Do you know her?
You're doing your pole, Rachel. You're bumped. Body ain't broken, broke you. I bet your son's gonna get hurt. And you don't want that, do you? Do ya?
No, no.
You're giving me too much trouble, Rachel. Then I don't want any trouble. You understand? Do you understand? Do you understand? Do you get it?
Rachel!
Mom?
Rachel, I heard you. I know you're in there, Rachel.
Rachel?
He tried to kill us.
What?
Help us. Help us.
Are you a policeman?
No. You're not the first person to ask me that. Do you think I look like a policeman?
Not really. Do you know what I want to be when I grow up?
No, what?
An astronaut. Well, or an astronomer. To go to Jupiter on an expedition. Did you know that they've never sent anyone to explore it?
Well, maybe they're waiting to send you. So you can be the first.
Come on, buddy. Time for bed.
Is he
obviously.
Thank you. Listen, that man...
I don't want to know. I don't know who you are, Rachel. And that's fine. I just want this. And I've got it.
But you helped us. You could have called the police. You could have taken that and just left. But you brought us here. You're a good man.
I'm a scared man. That's what I am.
And a little sad. Why is that so important?
All I know is that there's someone willing to do anything to get it back.
The people who killed Lydia.
Doesn't matter.
That woman wanted us to find it, I'm certain of it.
If she wanted us to find it, great, we have found it. And now I'm going to give it back. End of story.
And then what? I killed a man. They're going to come after me.
Then leave.
No, I can't. I have nothing. I have nowhere to go.
You have your son. You can still change your life.
What about you?
It's time.
Something I didn't tell you. Lydia sent me a letter some months ago. I hadn't heard from her in years. I was scared.
I thought there would be something evil in the words.
Professor, I appreciate you calling me, but...
You don't understand. I think Lydia knew you were coming to see me. I think the letter was for you.
Ha, ha, ha.
Welcome, Mr. Solomon. We were expecting you. You can call me Jacqueline. It's a French name. Do you like it?
No.
You're an insolent man. That does not befit a poet.
I'm not a poet.
One who gave up writing. What a waste. If you only knew what you are missing. There's a line by Cavafy that can produce blisters filled with pus and the high fever and a very brief Neruda that explodes like a nuclear plant. Poetry can do incredible things.
I didn't come here to see party tricks.
No, of course not. We have matters to deal with, do we not?
First, you have to give me your word. You will not harm us.
You have your own conditions? You should stop drinking whiskey, Mr. Solomon.
The girl and the child. No one. If I give you what you want, forget about us forever.
I want to see it. Did you by any chance come here to trick us, Mr. Solomon? Well, someone did. It's obvious. It seems that girl of yours is not to be trusted.
Samuel?
Rachel, open the door.
Who is it?
You know who I am. Please open the door. They can't see me here.
Lydia. You're starting to remember.
That's impossible. I saw you die.
They had to believe that.
Why?
You still don't remember, but you will.
My baby.
No. No. No, it wasn't because of your baby. That was an excuse. It was because of you. You're different. You've always been different. You can feel things. They'll never...
What about you?
I'm with you. We have a plan. That's why I'm here. You will remember. We were so lucky that insignificant man came along. Samuel. Jacqueline's puzzled. doesn't understand what he has to do with any of it.
You called him. The dreams, like you called me.
Yes. Tell her I'm out of practice.
What do you want?
You know exactly what I want.
You can't have it. You can't take it from me. I remember the rules.
Of course. The rules. The ones you don't follow. But that's not why I'm here.
Mom?
Go back to bed, buddy.
I've been expecting you for a long time.
Secrets must be kept, Professor. You should have learned that by now. Don't exert yourself. That's Yates. They won't let you move. Don't be afraid. This one is very short. But it's going to keep you alive for hours. We didn't want you to miss out on anything.
What did you do?
They took my son.
What? I just wanted that thing. Why didn't you give it to me?
Couldn't. I remembered. Our power, our memory, this is eternity. Without it, we're just pieces of flesh.
I've seen them. And you're not like that.
That's why they hate me. They hate everything that seems human because they'll never be able to have it. But I can love. They've been looking for a chance to banish me for centuries, any excuse. Then it happened. There are rules. There are hundreds of rules. A lady cannot bear children. It's forbidden. That gave them a reason. They could have just destroyed it and let me to die like any human, but no. They wanted more. They buried it and they voided it. I lost my power. I forgot everything. And then they sold me to that man. But my eternity would remain intact. So the punishment would never end. Then Lydia got it back. She was different too. In her own way. She always wanted to help me. They must have found out somehow, and that's why they killed her.
There can't be.
There is a way. A ritual.
The White Ring.
Lydia could see the future. She's been guiding us from the beginning.
Why me?
Maybe she thought I needed help.
Kill me, I'm sure of it. As long as we have the Imago, they'll keep me alive. I took it, I have to give it back. Those are the rules. This is the only thing that's protecting us. What?
Number 7.
Seen her. She's the cruelest, the most dangerous, but she's also the weakest. If she dies, they all die. That's why she hides.
Where?
The receptacle. Nobody knows what it is.
Wait. Lydia. Maybe she knew.
Oh, she wanted to help us. She would have told us somehow. Lydia knew they were watching her. That's why she was being so cryptic.
Yeah, and that's why she sent the letter to Roshan.
And hid the photo in the frame. She knew it would lead you to him.
Professor? Hello? Professor?
Professor, is that you?
Have taken it.
The key.
They are all gone into the world of light, and I alone sit lingering here. Their very memory is fair and bright, and my sad thoughts to the clear.
It's Milton. I'm sure of it.
To mean something.
I don't know. But I know someone who will.
It's open.
Oh, fuck.
Susan? Susan?
What have they done to you? When did they do this to you? Oh my God, what are you doing? Damn it, stop it! Stop it! Stop!
My Rose, that one's sick.
What does it mean?
She's gonna devour herself.
Well, there must be some way we can stop it.
There's nothing we can do.
You stop the nurse, maybe you can do it.
Didn't stop the nurse, I killed him. Do you want me to do that now?
Maybe we can cut it out.
What?
Go get a knife.
I don't think that'll work.
Down in the kitchen, in the end of the hallway. Bring whatever you can find. No! Susan, please stop it. Stop it. Find her something to tie. Tie her up. I'm not going to hurt you, but I'm going to have to stop you doing this to yourself.
I'm so sorry.
I got it.
All right. Turn around.
Get it.
All right, I'm going to get you onto the bed now, all right? You'll be okay up there. All right, shush, now help me. Here we go. Just try to breathe.
She'll start doing it again and she won't stop. I'm sorry.
What if they keep her safe? Or they sedate her or something?
She can still help us. You have to show her the verse. They have my son. You've no idea what they're capable of. Please.
Call an ambulance.
Sorry to have to ask you this, but I need your help. I need you to tell me what this means. They are all gone into the world of light, and I alone sit lingering here. Their very memory is fair and bright, and I shall forced off. It's Milton, isn't it? You're the expert.
Oh,
tell me.
No.
You tell me what.
No. Not Milton.
What? The power of Susan. What does it mean? What is it?
Let me go. Let me go.
Susan, please.
Let me go.
I'm sorry. The poem. What does it mean?
Beyond the veil.
Susan.
It won't be long. What'd she tell you?
Is the title of the poem. Why didn't she just write down an address? If she wanted to tell us.
Wait, beyond the veil. She did. Port train, lunatic asylum. Room 1007. This is the place.
I know it. It's in Dollar Bay. Lydia sent the letter from there 6 months ago. But it's been closed for years.
We have to go. Now.
No. We have to wait for the ambulance.
No, we
can't leave Susan like this. She's my friend.
Then I'll wait outside.
An ambulance on its way. I'll be here any minute. Do you hear me, Susan? Everything will be just as before. I promise. I'll go back to the university like you wanted.
Think I can help her? I'm remembering.
How?
I'm not sure, but I can try. Leave me alone with her.
Susan!
Got you.
I wouldn't go in there if I were you, Mr. Solomon. Receptacle. Whatever it is, it has to be in there. That's where she's hiding. We'll have to be ready.
What happens when she dies?
They all will. To hurry. Won't take them long to find us.
We're 1,007. There's nothing in here.
It has to be. The message is clear.
What if you were wrong?
No. You love forever. What's wrong?
What is that?
Peace out of place. Now everything fits.
No.
Samuel.
No.
Samuel.
Who is it, Samuel? Tell me. Think about how you met her. How she appeared in your life. It was all part of a plan.
Stop!
She made you fall in love with her, didn't she? And then she left. Oh, because she knew you'd never be able to forget her. You were the perfect hiding place.
No! No!
She's inside you, Samuel. She's in your heart.
I want to get her out of my heart.
I know how to do that. But you have to tell me how it happened.
What are you doing?
Help me. Tear this off.
The white ring.
Come on. I'm gonna need you now. Follow me.
What do you need me to do?
We'll trick her. We have to smuggle her. Yes. Take off your coat. If the receptacle is in danger, if your body is hurt, she'll be forced to come out. Give me your arm. We'll have to be quick. When she comes out, she'll sense that she's in danger and she'll turn violent. We have to put her in the circle. That will immobilize her. And that'll be the moment. Samuel, you're gonna have to kill her. There's no other way.
I don't want you to die.
Promise me. Take care of my son. Always. Promise me you love him. Please.
to her. Mom, please. Please, 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 I go, please.
Lying to you, Samuel. She has no idea what we were.
Don't listen to her. Kill her.
Look at me, Samuel. It's me. Samuel, do you remember?
Kill her.
No, don't do it, don't.
Kill her.
No, don't listen to her, please.
Do it.
I know.
You're not Beatrice.
No, don't say
that. You're not Beatrice. She was a lie.
Oh, my love is not that simple. I'm a lot of things at the same time.
No, 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 no. She's lying to you. She's lying to you. Kill her.
Look at me. I could have chosen anyone.
She's lying.
But I chose you. Do you know why?
Do it. Do it. Kill her.
Because I loved you.
No, 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 no.
You know it.
No. She's lying. Look at me.
You promised. Do you remember? You promised me you would love me forever.
What? Kill her. Kill her!
Your son, alone in this mediocre world. That wouldn't be a good end for this story, would it?
This is how that story ends. The saddest story of them all. Like all stories, one day, it will be forgotten. All that will remain will be a trace of black ink on a piece of paper. But I know it was real. I know she was real. And I know that one day we will find a way to bring her back. Poetry can do incredible things.